Hello and welcome to another exciting video. So we've looked at beats in 4-4 time, we've looked at beats in 3-4 time, and right now we're going to look at beats in 6-8 time. There's also, to follow this video, beats in odd time signatures, and the ones I've looked at in the following videos is 5-8, 5-4, 7-8, 7-4. But at the moment we're going to look at 6-8, okay? So how 3-4 and 6-8 are generally thought about on the drum kit is as such. 3-4 is three quarter notes, yeah? The top number is telling you how many beats in the bar, which is 3. And the lower number, I'm talking about the time signature, the lower number is the type of beat, okay? So the top number is 3, the lower number is 4. The 4 stands for quarter, right? So there's three lots of quarter notes in the bar. So when we play a 3-4 beat, a common way of playing it, or a common way of thinking about it when playing the drums, is to take your 6/8 notes and break them like this. So 3 quarters obviously has 6/8, right? So you break the 8th notes up into quarters. So you get 1 and 2 and 3 and 1 and 2 and 3 and, okay? 1 and 2 and 3 and, we'll go a bit slowly. 1 and 2 and 3, I'm at 100 beats per minute. So I'm counting actually. 1 and 2 and 3 and, 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 1 and 2 and 3. Similar to that. 1, 2, 3, 1 and 2 and 3 and, 1 and 2 and 3 and, 1 and 2 and 3 and. So you can see those 6/8 notes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3. Broken up into 1 and 2 and 3 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1 and 2 and 3 and. So that's kind of how it's dispersed with on the drum kit. 3, 4 is dispersed like that. 1, 2, 3 or 1 and 2 and 3 and 1 and 2 and 3. Anyway, if you want to know more about 3-4 beats in detail, look back to the beats in 3-4, and if you want to look at the ones in 4-4, look back to those ones. So we're here really, aren't we, to talk about 6-8. So 6-8 is broken like this on the kit. Still has its 6/8 notes, so 6 lots of 8th notes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. But we get this. We don't break the 6/8 into quarters, so we don't into 3 quarters. So we don't go 1 and 2 and 3 and, we go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Which if you try to count 1 and 2 and 3 and over, this is what happens. 1 and 2, 1 and 2 and 3 and, 1 and 2 and 3 and. If you were to count over the top of it. But I'm going to count how it makes sense to count, because we're in 6/8 here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now the thing is, it's easier eventually to go 1, 2, 1, 2. Unless it's a very slow kind of 6-8, like a. Then we might count all the faster pulses, or the smaller pulses, or the smaller beats. So that's 6-8, typical 6-8 feel. If I play the crash cymbal on the first of every 6, 5-6, 4-5-6, compared to 1-5-6, actually what I'll do is I'll dot and dot between 3-4 and 6-8, watch. 1-5-6, 4-5-6, 4-5-6, 4-5-6, 4-5-6, 4-5-6, 4-5-6, 4-5-6, 4-5-6, 4-5-6, 4-5-6, 4-5-6, 4-5-6, 4-5-6, 4-5-6, 4-5-6, 4-5-6, 4-5-6, 4-5-6, 4-5-6, 4-5-6, 4-5-6, 4-5-6, 4-5-6, 4-5-6, 4-5-6, 4-5-6, 4-5-6, 4-5-6, 4-5-6, 4-5-6, 4-5-6, 4-5-6, 4-5-6, 4-5-6, 4-5-6, 4-5-6, 4-5-6, 4-5-6, 4-5-6, 4-5-6, 4-5-6, 4-5-6, 4-5-6, 4-5-6, 4-5-6, 4-5-6, 4-5-6, 4-5-6, 4-5-6, 4-5-6, 4-5-6, 4-5-6, 4-5-6, 4-5-6, kind of comparing the two, and you know, it's a pretty common way of playing them. Say if we did 12-8, you could play. I mean, in reality, you might not actually do this all the time, but I was going to say in 12-8, you could play a cymbal on the first of every 12 instead of every 6. If you're playing in a 12-8 kind of song, you'd hear or someone would decipher that they're hearing a stronger kind of accent, if you like, on the first of every 12 instead of the first of every 6. So it might be piano chords where the vocals start, what the drums are doing as far as where cymbals are being played or accented. That's a difficult one to call, to whether one is 12 or 6. Anyway, if I give you just a 6-8 with a cymbal on the first beat of 6, and I think what I'll do is I'll count 6 and I'll also count the two big beats, okay? So look, let me do the 6 and then do the same for the 12. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now I count the two longer pulses or big beats. 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. Now I'll do 12-8. I'm just going to play the cymbal on the first of every 12. And I'm going to count all the way up to 12. I'll do that twice. Then I'll carry on playing the cymbal on the first beat, but I'll count the four larger beats or longer beats or bigger pulses. And I'll do that twice. So count up to 12. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. And now I count the bigger beats. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. That kind of thing. They're used in a lot of that kind of rhythm, or the kind of beat pattern I'm playing there, is used in a lot of blues music. Rhythm and blues music is where you tend to see these patterns. Gospel music, yeah, there you go. So excuse me, so if I was to play some fill-ins just to decorate it up a little bit, we'd kind of go. I'm setting a click track up. I should be telling you what speed I'm doing the clicker at. We go at 60 beats a minute. 1, 2, 3, 2, 2. Yeah. So the dotted, that's a quite a nice pulse. The dotted quarter note in this case is 60 beats per minute. So basically each pulse is worth 3/8 notes. Look, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So there's 3 1/8 notes to every dotted quarter note pulse, or dotted crotchet pulse if you like. So I'm making the dotted quarter note the beat, and I'm saying that that dotted quarter note is running at 60 beats per minute. That's one thing I should mention actually. So the difference between, so 3/4, like 4/4 and 2/4, the pulse is broken into two little, it's a simple time signature, so the pulse is broken into two little notes, 2/8. So 1, 2, 3, 4. So hang on. 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. So you know. 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. Well, you don't say that, do you? Go 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. 4, 4, 3, 4. You go 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Is what you count for the 6 and the 12/8. We've gone through how you count those, and I've sort of touched upon deciphering whether something's 6/8 or 12/8, and what might tend to lead you to think it's one or the other. It's quite subjective. Now, what I was going to do, wasn't it, is to play some fill-ins, right? And that's what I'm going to do. So let's get rocking. Let's get rolling. Let's do like a 12-8 kind of blues feel, and I'll do some fill-ins to decorate it, embellish it a little bit. Let's roll the dice. I'm on 60 dotted quarter notes per minute. 60 dotted quarter note beats per minute. Beats per minute is usually abbreviated to BPM, beats per minute. Let's fly the kite and roll the Royce. Do do that. So, like a ba do da do do. Okay, and that is a rundown of 6/8 time. And I recapped on what 3/4 was. So also I should add that when we were saying about 3/4, the pulse is broken into two little notes, so two eighth notes or two quavers actually. So the quarter note pulse in 3/4, 2/4, or 4/4. The crotchet pulse then, also known as the quarter note pulse, is broken into two little notes, which are quavers. Or 2/8 notes if you're talking in the other language. And 6/8 and 12/8, the big pulse is broken into three little notes. And that is called compound time, okay? So when we were talking about 2/4, 3/4, and 4/4, when we were talking about those, the main beat being broken into two little beats, which are 2/8, also known as two quavers, that's called simple time. And when we're talking about 6/8, 12/8, and the big beat is broken into, so the dotted quarter, also known as the dotted crotchet, when that's broken into three little notes, and those three little notes are 3/8 or three quavers. So the big beat is the dotted quarter or the dotted crotchet. The term used for those type of signatures, time signatures, is called compound, okay? So 2/4, 3/4, 4/4, simple, 6/8, 12/8. I did add 9/8 into there. We could 9/8. We'll do 9/8 on a different day for the minute. So let's just think of 6/8, 12/8. They're very commonly used in rock and roll bands and rhythm and blues bands. Compound time signatures. They're called compound time signatures. It's very worthwhile learning that kind of a feel for when you're playing in your band. Because if you're going to start in a band, you're likely to do songs with that kind of a time feel. If you're going to do musicals, concert band, brass band, there's always a good old 6/8 in those. They'll come up, so it's worth getting it down. That's about it. The fill-ins, maybe do a separate video for the fill-ins. I'm not saying learn everything. I wasn't trying to teach you. I was just giving you a feel for it. But you might be able to copy, pluck a few things out of there. But don't go worrying about that. Just try and get the actual pattern down. The 1, 2, 1, 5, 6, 1, 5, 6, 1, 2, 1, 2. Just get that down. Get used to doing the different counting, so all the way up to 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and the 1, 2, same for 12, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 1, 2, 3, 4. That's about it. That's enough to give you a good overview of compound time, I think. As I say, the videos after this will be dealing with odd time signatures, so your fives and your sevens. There's others as well. 11's a good one, but I've only done 5 and 7 because I think it's more than enough at the moment. Thanks very much, and good night.